Before white nose syndrome, you could go into one of these hibernation sites and see thousands, often tens of thousands of bats, depending on the size of the cave or mine. Now, when we go into the caves, there's many fewer bats, and it's very disheartening. White nose syndrome is a new disease that's been killing bats. It is a disease caused by an invasive fungus.
Little brown bats, which used to be the most common bat here in Michigan, are being devastated by the disease.
They're only affected by the white nose fungus in the winter. And so in order to document and collect bats that have died from the disease, we have to go into those caves and mines in the winter and collect dead bats.
We actually compare the genetic makeup of bats that we find dead in the caves and then bats that Giorgia has actually caught during the summer. So these bats have been exposed to the disease, and we can tell they've been exposed because you can see little lesions on their wings that shows they've been infected, but nonetheless they survive.
Based on our research, we found that the survivors have differences in some genes that are associated with regulating arousal from hibernation, regulating breakdown of fats, and interestingly, one gene involved in echolocation and communication. Because we found differences in genes associated with regulating hibernation and breakdown of fats, it could be that bats that are genetically predisposed to be a little bit fatter or sleep more deeply are less susceptible to the disease.
So the biggest news is we're in this very depressing situation where so many bats are dying from this, that we have common species that now are become very, very rare. And yet we're finding the hints that there could be these genetic changes that are occurring that might provide some type of survival in the future. So as these variants increase, there's some hope that these bats are not all going to die from the disease itself.